Hi everyone, welcome back to Hands-Free Studying for the MBE, brought to you by Brainscape.
These upcoming constitutional law questions cover federalism. All right, let's get started. Question one, police powers are reserved to the blank. To the states. The states are granted broad authority to enact legislation to promote the general welfare. Question two, what is the Supremacy Clause? The Supremacy Clause, found in Article 6, Paragraph 2, holds that if a federal law directly or indirectly conflicts with state law, the federal law will prevail and the state law will be declared void. Federal laws can either expressly or impliedly preempt state law. Question three, when does federal law expressly preempt state law? Federal law expressly preempts state law when either the law is an exclusive power of the federal government, for example, the power to conduct foreign affairs, or the regulation is in an area that has been expressly prohibited by the federal government. Now note, express preemption laws are narrowly construed. Question four, when does federal law impliedly preempt state law? Courts will infer federal intention to preempt if state law hinders the purpose of the federal law, state law makes compliance with federal law impossible, or Congress intended for the federal government to occupy the entire field, also known as field preemption. Question five, can states create laws that are more rigorous than those set by the federal government? Yes, in the absence of preemption, states can create more stringent laws than the federal government. Question six, what is the Dormant Commerce Clause? The Dormant Commerce Clause holds that since Congress has exclusive power to regulate interstate commerce, states are prohibited from discriminating against or unduly burdening interstate commerce, even if Congress has not explicitly regulated that activity. Question seven, when does a state regulation violate the Dormant Commerce Clause? The regulation can violate the Dormant Commerce Clause if the regulation discriminates against out-of-state commerce, unduly burdens interstate commerce, or regulates wholly out-of-state activity. Question eight, when does a regulation discriminate against out-of-state competition? It discriminates when it promotes the economic interests of its own residents at the expense of out-of-staters. For example, imposing requirements on out-of-state companies but not on in-state companies. Question nine, under the Dormant Commerce Clause, when are regulations that discriminate against out-of-staters valid? Regulations can be held valid if the regulation is necessary to achieve an important government interest and there's no reasonable non-discriminatory alternative, the state is a market participant, or the regulation involves traditional government functions, for example, trash collection, or lastly, if Congress has expressly authorized regulation. Question 10. If a regulation is non-discriminatory, it may nonetheless be struck down if it unduly burdens interstate commerce.
And that's the end of your 10 flashcard study round. To reach full mastery, remember to study in Brainscape. Our mobile and web app uses the latest in spaced repetition techniques, allowing you to optimize your study time and track your progress down to the finest detail. Of course, when you're driving, cooking, exercising, or otherwise unable to navigate the app, be sure to keep listening to the rest of this hands-free studying playlist. No matter what subject you're learning and what method you're studying it, Brainscape helps you rise to your challenge.